Hi everyone, it's the Math Sorcerer here with Chegg. In this video, we're going to discuss the determinant of a square matrix. Let's go ahead and do some examples of computing determinants. In part A, we have a matrix A, which is equal to the matrix with entries 1, 2, and 3, 1. This is a 2x2 matrix because you have two rows and two columns. Let's find the determinant solution. There's a formula for 2x2 matrices, which is very powerful. If you have a matrix A, and it's equal to, say, AB, CD, to find the determinant of this matrix, which I'll denote by just bars, putting bars like this around the A can mean determinant. You basically multiply the A and the D, so A times D, and then you subtract, and then it's B times C, so B times C, so AD minus BC. Let's apply it here to our example. So we have the determinant of A, that's equal to, so it would be 1 times 1, minus, and then 2 times 3. That's equal to determinant of A, which is equal to 1 minus 6, which is minus 5, right? Because this is 1 minus 6. Pretty easy, right? Not very difficult at all. So whenever you're looking for the determinant of a 2x2 matrix, you basically multiply these, 1 times 1, subtract, and then 2 times 3. Let's go ahead and do an example of the determinant of a larger matrix. So here we have a 3x3 matrix. A is equal to the matrix with entries 2, 3, 1, 1, 2, 0, and 0, 3, 4. And we're going to find its determinant solution. We're going to use something called cofactor expansion, which basically means that you pick a row or column and then expand along that row. So we can use the first row, second row, third row, or the first column, second column, or third column. Usually you want to pick things that have zeros. For example, using the first column is probably an easier way to do this problem, or using the second row or third column. Zeros are good, and you'll see why as we go through the problem. However, let's go ahead and use the first row because that's a really common choice. So the determinant of A is equal to, so we're going to expand along the first row. You start by writing down the coefficient, so 2, okay, because that's the number you see in the matrix. And then you always put a negative 1. And the exponent here is row plus column. So we're in the first row, first column, so 1 plus 1. And then what you do is you write down a matrix. This is the matrix that you get by crossing out the first row and first column. So if you cross out the first row and first column, you're left with 2, 0, 3, 4. 2, 0, 3, 4. So in this case, I'm going to write 2, 0, 3, 4. Again, you write down the number, which is 2. You always have a negative 1, and the exponent is row plus column. First row, first column, that gives us 1 plus 1. And then you cross out the corresponding row and column, and you take the determinant of the remaining submatrix, so 2, 0, 3, 4. It'll make a little more sense when we go to the next part, so plus. Now you go to the next number, so 3. Always have the negative 1, and it's row plus column. So we're in the first row, second column, right? First row, second column. The first row, second column is 1 plus 2. And then you have your little determinant here, which if you cross out the first row, second column, it's 1, 0, 0, 4. 1, 0, 0, 4. So we write 1, 0, 0, 4. Again, you cross out the first row and first column, and you take the determinant of the remaining submatrix, which is 1, 0, 0, 4. Hopefully you're starting to see the pattern now. So it's plus. The next coefficient is 1. You always have the negative 1. And then it's row plus column. This time we're in the first row, third column, so it's 1 plus 3. Then you multiply by the determinant of the remaining submatrix that you get when you cross out the corresponding row and column. So boom, boom, 1, 2, 0, 3. 1, 2, 0, 3. Write it, 1, 2, 0, 3. Let's go over that again from the beginning, because once you understand this, it's amazing. So you take the first number, that goes there, right? We're expanding along the first row, so we just take the numbers 2, 3, 1. So 2, it's always a negative 1, and it's row plus column. So first row, first column. First row, first column. Look what's left. 2, 0, 3, 4. Boom, there it is. Then we go to the next one, plus 3. We're in the first row, second column. First row, second column. First row, second column is 1 plus 2. Cross out the corresponding row and column. You're left with 1, 0, 0, 4. 1, 0, 0, 4. Boom, there it is. Then you go to the next one, so 1. 1. And then it's negative 1 to the row plus column. So we're in the first row, third column. That gives you the 1 plus 3. And notice we're left with this little matrix here. It's the determinant rather of 1, 2, 0, 3. And you can do this along any row or column, so multiple ways to do it. So you can see if we had used the first column, we'd have a 0 here at the end instead of a 1, and all of this would go away, so it would make our computation much easier. So continuing in this fashion, the determinant of A. So useful knowledge here is whenever you have negative 1 to an even number, it's going to be 1. And whenever you have negative 1 to an odd number, it's going to be negative 1, right? We're going to use these facts to help make the simplification easier. So for example here, it's really negative 1 squared, so it's just 1. That's 2 times 1, times, and then determinant here, 2 times 4, minus 0 times 3. And you can skip steps, I'm going to show all of them. Here we have negative 1 cubed, well, almost all of them. Negative 1 cubed is negative 1, so it'll be minus 3. Right, minus 3, because this becomes a minus 1, right? It's negative 1 cubed, 3 is odd, so you get minus 1. Then we do 1 times 4, minus 0 times 0, right, 0 times 0. And the last one is plus, because it's going to be 1 plus 3 is 4, so it's an even power of negative 1. And it's 1 times 3, whoops, 1 times, let me just make sure that's clear, 1 times 3, minus 2 times 0. It can get a little messy here when you start putting little dots for multiplication and stuff, so sometimes people skip steps. I mean, it's what you prefer, your preference. This is equal to, so here we have 2. 2 times 4 is 8, minus 0 is just 8. So 2 times 8, minus 3 times 4, right, because that's just going to be 4, plus 3 minus 0, right, because that's 2 times 0 is 0, so plus 3. So, yeah, the dots are a little confusing. They almost look like decimals, but that's what happens when you show all the work. I guess I could have put them in parentheses like this, but then you have a gazillion parentheses. That might be better. 2 times 8 is 16, minus 12 plus 3. So this is going to be the determinant of A is equal to 4 plus 3. So therefore, the determinant of A is the number 7. Very cool. And if you're wondering what are determinants for, basically one way you can think of a determinant is as a classification tool. If the determinant of a matrix is 0, you can't find the inverse. So yeah, so if you get 0, that means the matrix is not invertible. Anyways, hopefully you've learned some math in this video. This is a very useful technique, especially this example here. It's called cofactor expansion. And I believe it's also called Laplacian expansion, but cofactor is the more common name. Hopefully you've learned some math. And if you enjoyed this video, make sure to check out more videos on Chegg. Good luck.